Alright, you guys, are you guys good?
Alright. Greetings, we are Middle Kids. We are on the beautiful city Nashville at WNXP Station. And we're going to play you some songs. This one is called Stacking Chairs. You lift your heart in the jungle, ripped off of your red bicycle. I didn't know you then, but it feels significant. I gave up everything I learned just to follow you down that dirt road. You better hold my hand. There is no map for this.
I'll be stacking the chairs. When the world turns on you, I will be there. Yeah, I will be
so far from the people who are nearest.
All right, this song is called Cellophane Brain.
Never quite on time, running late, running wild, looking up star signs, eating apples on the chain. I know you say it's alright as you keep it inside. Hey, when did you realize there's no guy with the first prize waiting at the end? Cellophane, you shake, you never change. Cellophane, you're strange up in your brain. Are you afraid to stop and find a reason why you can't get away from it? Moving up the coastline, making deals, selling houses, promise of the good life. Compliance teams, bleak routines, nothing more sad than a man who cries in his car in the driveway. Blue helium light, blinking again. Change cellophane, you're a stranger up in your brain. Are you afraid to stop and find a reason why you can't get away from it? Cellophane, you shake, you never change. Silkwood carbon, of course, again. You think you're a black umbrella holding off the rain. I think you're a silkwood carbon, of course, again. Cellophane, you shake, you never change. Cellophane, yeah, you're strange up in your brain.
I'm Jason Moon Wilkins. We're here inside the Sonic Cathedral at WNXP with Middle Kids. If you guys want to introduce yourselves around the horn there real quick.
Hey, I'm Tim.
I'm Hannah.
And I'm Harry.
And together we are
Middle Kids.
Two albums in and you already... What happened to the harmony?
Tim will not participate in such tomfoolery.
I didn't know about that.
Very spontaneous.
That's right.
Well, it's fantastic to be in a room with you. The last time you and I talked, we were... I don't know how many miles away to Australia.
Am I supposed to know that?
I don't know. I don't know.
Many.
You were in Australia in your home, and it was Zoom, and we weren't sure when any of this would commence. You know what would happen. And we talked about you making the record and what that was like in this time. And you guys have kind of had a unique experience with this, where some people, we even did a whole series of Nashville artists who released albums during the pandemic and then kind of went through their whole cycle that way. Mm-hmm. And what that was like for them emotionally, how they navigated it. For you guys, it's kind of been both, right? You released a record earlier this year. It seems like even longer ago because of how crazy this year has been. But now you have been able to go out. Has it felt almost like a split time for you?
Yeah, I think so. I think it was a lot of that general pandemic
being a band experience like you're describing, just a lot of nothing for a while, except, you know, some press stuff. But then, yeah, it's been amazing. Like, it was really hard to get this tour to go ahead, to come over from Australia. But once we've been on it for the last 5 weeks, it's been feeling like, oh, this is like what you do when you've released an album. You tour it, and it's been really cool to see the fans connect to it and to be able to play the songs kind of for the first time, except for a few Australian shows in the rooms. So it's been great.
Yeah. Well, and getting to go out there and actually, it's almost somewhat reverse order. Obviously, some people, you know, make a record and it's completely wholly done apart from the road. But a lot of times you do test songs out. You get a chance to hear what they're like and what the audience reacts to. Have you seen, you've been out for 5 weeks here, have you seen that evolution of the way these songs kind of were as recorded pieces and now what they've become with audience reaction?
I mean, that's been a really special part of this tour for me. I think for all of us is that, because I think, you know, we really get to know the record while we play it, and we haven't been able to do that. And then, yeah, kind of hearing it from the fans as well. And so it's been really cool to see like songs resonating with them, and even like kind of surprising seeing people sing the songs. And I'm like, I feel like I barely know this song, like, because I feel like we really get to know it playing it like night after night. And so kind of almost felt like we were doing that journey with everybody. Yeah. So it's been cool, because I almost felt like when we released a record and we weren't playing it, kind of felt just detached from it a little bit. So yeah, it's been this cool time of just nestling into the songs, if that's a thing.
It is. Well, know that I guess you can see it with the streaming numbers, but you know that people were singing along out there. You couldn't feel it, you know. We certainly, I remember talking to the folks who work with Radio For You, and they were like, okay, well, what's the next single? I'm like, I don't know, pick a song. There's so many, you know, good songs that to sing along with on this record. And you've made me look good, by the way, with my own family, who saw you out in Oregon earlier this year.
Oh, really?
You know, you work in this part of the world. I'm sure it happens to you guys. What are you listening to? And it's always hard, because you go, I don't know, I'm listening to all kinds of things. But I go, you know what? Everyone who I've said, go listen to this record, Middle Kids Today, The Greatest, has come back and been, oh my God, you were so right. It's amazing.
That's awesome. Oh, that's so nice.
So I've helped you sell a couple of t-shirts. I don't get any commission or anything like that.
Thank you.
We'll give you a hat. A great bucket hat.
Oh, you know what? I love hats.
Okay.
I'm in. So I read before, you know, when you have developed songs, that a lot of your, I mean, this is only the second record, but you've had EPs, you know, you've been around for a while as a band, that part of your rhythm was writing songs on tour, working on some of this stuff and then coming back. Have you fallen back into that rhythm, or is it still sort of readjusting to road life? Have you been working on new things, even on this tour?
Well, I think, you know, had to really find other ways to write songs with not touring.
Yeah.
So the last year I was like trying to figure out how to like dig into the well whilst not being on the road, and kind of getting there. But I've even been like I think we've all been very like creatively inspired just from this tour alone. So we started making things kind of earlier this year as well. But I think we feel this renewed sense of creativity and kind of vision for the next record, which is really exciting. And I think it is a testament to that touring energy that I think influences us a lot and kind of makes sense with our personalities, or mine anyway, I don't know.
Yeah. Well, and while you've been out, you've obviously been able to experience playing in this unprecedented time in different places. Has it been different state to state, different country to country? Like, and I guess how has that, you know, I guess, is there anyone who has done it better than others where you feel like, okay, this is the way we get back into this thing?
I mean, it's definitely been different going state to state around here. And even like, you know, the whole response to the last 18 months between America and Australia is very different. But I actually feel like one thing is that's been kind of unanimous is that the people's response to just being back in that live music space, and, you know, seems like something that was universally missed. And, you know, both us and it seems like the fans just so appreciative to be back, and the response has just kind of been overwhelming. And it was hard to even anticipate, I guess, because we hadn't done it so much for so long, you know. I kind of had lost touch with that feeling. But yeah, every show we've done in every corner of the country has just, that's kind of been noticeable, which is kind of nice. You know, it feels like a strange time and a divided time, but it, every now and then there are just things that bring it all back together, and it's nice to feel like you're in that zone.
And I think too, we played some shows in Australia, and you know, some of the ways that we were doing that to kind of control it a little more, we're having seated gigs, mm-hmm. which was like fine because we were just stoked to be playing shows. But here they were all like standing gigs, and just the energy of that was like so exciting and almost like such a relief to have that back, because you realize there is so much energy that transfers between that. And I guess, you know, we're further along now in terms of people being vaccinated, so we can have those spaces filled more. But I think that we feel like America's just, you know, doing a great job at kind of like learning how to like create these spaces as safe as you can, you know, in these crazy times. So
yeah.
We've been really thankful for, you know, and like our fans have been like so respectful of like all the venues policies of like, you know, proof of negative tests or masks or whatever. And I think, you know, we just feel so thankful that everyone's just trying to like rally together to like be able to participate in this way.
Yeah.
It's been really cool.
Well, that's great. Well, I can't let you get out of here without a Nashville specific question. You know, listening to this record and living with it now for quite some time, you know, and I've lived here for quite some time in Nashville, it definitely seems to have this appeal that I know other songwriters, music publishers, other people, you know, would like and can hear, because it's such a strong sense of melody on there, such strong lyricism. Have people reached out to you about collaborating? You know, have you been pulled at all into the world of in Nashville co-writing? You know, and I don't mean just here, but like elsewhere.
We have a little bit. It's like not heaps in Nashville, but I think a lot of it is just a time and place thing,
mm-hmm.
for us to like be here. Like every now and then we'll do some collaborative like writing in the middle of a tour if we've got a couple of days. But I think we haven't done heaps of it. We'd like to do more, but we tried to do like a few Zoom ones over COVID,
yeah.
which is actually pretty cool that you can make music like that. I think we'd love to spend more time, particularly in Nashville, just to kind of be in that energy.
Yeah.
It's very different to Sydney, and but we just really haven't had that kind of like space, you know, just doing these laps around the country. We've got to probably sit still a bit more, you know?
Yeah, we're going to be here for a few days. So anyone reach out if you
want.
For
a collab.
Look us up in the yellow pages.
Yeah, that's right.
You'll probably get some Airbnb, you know, offers now, like, hey, come stay at my place. And then also, can you co-write with me?
Yeah, that's
because it's Nashville and everybody writes songs.
Yes. So
the currency here.
Sing it, for it your supper.
Well, thank you so much for joining us and for being here, and looking forward to seeing you play finally. I'm Jason Moon Wilkins, WNXP, and we've been talking to the Middle Kids.
Yo!
See ya.
Thanks.